to everyone. It's been a busy days changing the new workplace and stuff like that, and now I started to do this kind of thingy. It will be some kind of a rotating device. So this flange has the fitting for this electric motor and this kind of gear ratio, and on the other side it will be coming this kind of belt drive, and here we have moving thing that will shift the placement of the axle of this head. So maybe we will one day find out that what this machine will be, but first we have to build some parts. Let's make some kind of holder for this axle over here. I'm doing this placement for this bearing, and it's 32 millimeters outside, and now the hole is something like 24 millimeters, so we have plenty of travel to increase the diameter of the hole what we are drilling. So we need to adjust this head and move the sled to higher diameter. There is this locking screw. And on the one head there is coarse feed, and then there is fine feed for the head. This is 1/100 of millimeters per one marking, and this is 1 millimeter per one click. 1 and 2. Let's go first on the range. We have quite much to go. Certain diameter and pretty close to the within few millimeters, not so close yet, but time to start to train how to get accurate readings for the diameter. So now this is saying 28.32. It's time to go with the fine tuning with the head. So our reading is pretty much 1600s over 30 millimeters. So we should be getting a little bit over 32 millimeters to fit the bearing in. So let's make it slightly bigger. Notice that I can't calculate anymore, so I have to eat something. It's always like the same thing. Then if the doing is too complicated or something like that, I forget to eat. And I already lost the calculation or the count on the adjustment, so I did put something and now I have to do some test cut and then to measure once again. But it goes always the same. And I know that this is not the right tool for measuring hundreds, but this is the only tool that I have, so that's the one you are gonna use. And those are just numbers. So 75. $31.99. I believe that it will go there. Should be just fine. I'm gonna do one thing. Gonna plane this top because it's a little bit out of the dimension, this thickness, so. Let's use this as a planer. We need to open the feed lock. And take the stroke a little bit back. Like that, and then we are ready to go. Okay, we have now done the other side of the bearing holder, so this should go here, but I am not yet pressing it in. Have to check a little bit other things also, that how it will go. I did make this part so that it's done with two different pieces. These were the only stuff that I had, so they are pinned together. So maybe that I'm hoping that the shaft, when it's assembled over here, it will keep these pieces together, so it will just give some kind of for the shaft. This will give the support this structure. So we need to get bearings on both sides. This side is missing the slot for the bearing. So now we have to find out the center line on the other side. It might be a little bit difficult, but let's try to do that. And once we get this into the mill, I would like to make this kind of grooves also, that we could fit over to these places, so it becomes possible to shift it a little bit on the lengthwise. So then it's possible to have some kind of tightening for the belt. Of course the belt will be loosest on the middle, and when it's shifting to the ends, it will be most tight on the end strokes. But it's kind of the functionalities of this thing too, so hoping that it would function even without that. If this length would be continuously same, it should be some kind of curved ray or radius on the slot, but we have only direct moving part, so it will be 1 or 2 millimeters shorter in this middle position, but it shouldn't be any problem, I guess. Then other things what will be coming is that there will be a air cylinder doing this movement, so we'll have to check that how this fits in. But next thing is to make the bearing hole and some kind of grooves for these grooves for screws. It's now ready for this fixing. I guess I have to find some screws that are better for this purpose. We would need one more. are pretty close. Okay, once this is finished, it's possible to change the speed of the gearbox. Okay, thanks for watching this time. I'm having some parts ordered from China and some parts I need to make myself more to make this function also. You need probably to wait few weeks, I guess, that this will be finished. So be seeing you after we have some progress in this project. Thanks for watching and bye.